an entrepreneur in food businesses, a delicatessen in a restaurant. My gaze turned in 2012. It was an unexpected turn as London welcomed the Olympics. I uncovered a new golden era of creativity and science, with new publications coming out, of more available files online, scientists going on to YouTube, and the blossoming molecular gastronomy scene after the closure of elBulli restaurant, Ferran Adrià's iconic place in Spain the summer before. This new generation of chefs exploded onto the scene. So let's jump right in there now. Hello, Hendo here, and welcome to How I Discovered Molecular Pairing in Whisky. In this video, I'll tell you the backstory behind a more scientific way to pair food and whisky together. To learn more about food and drink pairings, sensory science, and marketing from a global perspective, please like this video, subscribe, and click the notification bell to find more valuable insights from Hendo. For years, I'd hosted whisky tasting nights in my whisky room and complement with the different whiskies, different foods. I owned a delicatessen, so I had the food supply chain and knew a lot of the artisan producers locally. And they would be more sophisticated each year. And my background really comes from hospitality. In the early 20s, I trained as a chef in Munich in Germany. Then went front of house, cocktail bartender, and then on to front of house, and then managed my own restaurant, delicatessen. So this is where the inspiration, I was always a foodie at the start of this journey. And I left Scotland when I was 18, traveled the world. The time I sold my delicatessen, I had visited many Michelin star restaurants and visited chateaus and distilleries in Scotland. So I was well on my way to being a super geeky, creative upstart. In June 2012, I hosted a whisky tasting in the Merchant's House in Glasgow. And I get such incredible feedback. People said that I should really take it further. Between projects at the time, and I decided to go for it. It was really more driven by the thought of making food and drinks creative, make them more about being a centrepiece rather than a sideshow at functions and events. And that's what kind of drove me forward. So if you have in the comments, please tell us a time that maybe it's happened to you. We've been super creative and you've gone on the impulse and decided to start up a business on it. So this was in the same era of the Ferran Adrià elBulli generation disperso across the globe, molecular gastronomy. So these chefs pushing boundaries, redefining cooking, and inspired so many different people. And I was one of them, heavily inspired, along with the publications, those new understanding of sensory science and YouTube videos and new books coming out as well at this time. So there's so much information I was consuming and taking all in during this period, fed my imagination. The perception of food and drink interactions really opened out during this era to the wider public. I found myself going to lectures at science festivals to find all the information. There was books, a lot of books published between 2012 and 2014, Taste of Molecules, Diane Fresquez. You had Taste Buds and Molecules by Francois, Chartier, Dr. Charles Spence, A Perfect Meal, Neurogastronomy by Gordon Shepard, Herve is Molecular Gastronomy. So all these were happening at this time, and this actually inspired me to set up the business I had at the time, Scotch Broth Events. But to be specific on how I discovered molecular pairing, it was accumulation of these things that were going on at the time. But also when I went to like brand launches or whisky events, where there was a dinner I was invited to or what have you, often found that fantastic storytelling, craftsmanship, really inspirational. And then when it came to the pairing or it came to dinner, a glass of wine would appear. It just wasn't the same confidence. And this is where I saw a gap. This was what I saw as an opportunity. a defining moment for me personally was with this book, the book Taste Buds and Molecules by sommelier consultant elBulli, Francois Chartier. A life's work, the science behind wine pairing. I was studying and graduating in a WSET wine spirits qualification at the time. While reading this book, really opened my eyes to the synergies in wine barrel science and whiskey aromas. This book is specifically wine focused, but I couldn't help noticing the relevance in whiskey. I cross-referenced science publications online to verify. It was clear that wine science was much further down the road than whiskey science at the time. Whiskey as a liquid is as complex as wine, and there's very heavily influenced, like wine, on what happens in the cask. So the aroma compounds that make up a large part of our taste experience. So with the knowledge of the sensory science, you know, high percentage of our taste perception and taste experience is through aroma. So to understand the aromatic volatile compounds in the wine knowledge and notice that they have similarities with similar barrels in the whiskey, I found that this is where I could translate over these aroma compounds relevant to whiskey, knowing that there wasn't really enough information in the whiskey world out there for it. There was some science, of course, but really this opened out a whole new world for me to understand these aromatic volatile compounds. Whiskey lactones jumped out the page at me. There was aromatic volatile compounds that reflected the tasting notes that we know and love. So if you take guaiacol, phenols for the smoky whiskey, eugenols for the sherry cask whiskey, you have furfurols, maltol, and these build the flavours as they take the cask, lignins break down in the charred casks, and this seeps into the whiskey, develops over time maturation into the final product, and we can put names to these tasting notes in aromatic volatile compounds. A chemical basis of flavour was formed. So instead of saying green apples in a classic Speyside Scotch whiskey, you could say acetaldehyde. This was like a brave new world. I felt like Charlie in the Chocolate Factory when this penny dropped for me. Driven by these new findings, I would research further. My kitchen became a lab. I would have industry friends around, chefs, drinks, and we would have interactions, experimenting, brainstorming, getting the books out. It was really creative time. But also at the same time, I was aware of it might be a bit science heavy to give to guests. So I kind of looked at the idea of the wine casks, because a big trend at the time was coming through in Scotch whiskey, a lot of wine cask finishes. So I thought this would be a really interesting opportunity and a way to present it. So my first collaboration was with a wine merchant, Majestic Wines in Glasgow, at their annual wine tasting event. Now I would have wine cask finished whiskey paired molecular with canopies, and this is where I would start. So it was experimental, but I had the information, the knowledge I brought together, but I just thought that would be a good way to go in rather than with cold hard science on its own. It worked very well, fantastic success, great feedback, and this would be the launch pad for me with this. We went on to present at international science festivals and events around the globe. So special thanks to all the people at that time inspired me. It'll be the scientists, the authors, the publications, contributors, industry colleagues, chefs, friends, family. I couldn't have done it without them. Tell us what you think of molecular pairing discovery. Is it something you've experienced firsthand? Have you got other questions? As always, welcome in the comments. I hope this has been useful to you. And until next time, thanks for watching.